long as you practice the Yi Jing Jing one time per week, it doesn't matter which one you make. Not at all. It makes no difference at all which version of it you use. But when you really understand that this is a method to keep your body, to keep the muscles and keep the tendons and keep the flexibility of your body in this life, if you have understood that this is a method to just keep the body vital and still flexible, and you want to use it for a long time, then sometimes it makes sense that some exercises are a little bit more specialized than others. I think you saw the first video of the Yi Jing Jing there was on this place here, and there I only make so. I make even so. Only. Also one way. Yeah, but here, for example, it's mainly the focus is here on this area and the head, the spine. So one is here, the other one is the spine. And now we made it here. Now it's going throughout the whole body. Sink down. One. Same. Return back. Knees and elbows move in the same amount. Yeah? When the knees are straight, the elbows are straight. When the knees start to bend, elbow bend. Same here. Stretch, stretch, stretch. When the knees bend, elbow bend. When you get straight again, and like said yesterday, when you make the exercise, that always check for your heartbeat and for the way how you're breathing. It is said that when the breathing is very calm, so when you cannot hear your breathing, so you must breathe so soft that you cannot hear your own breathing. When it is so soft, then the chi flows better. Then the chi flows better. Then there's more free flow. Yeah. So try to avoid that you are starting to breathe hard. When you're making hard breathing or anything, or you get out of breath, you put too much effort into the qigong. Qigong, relax. Relax, relax, relax. And then also here. Already here, start watching at Lao Gong it's called. Watch and at the same time feel. feel which areas, which tendons, which muscles, which part of your body is it that right now is like working. Relax. Soft, very calm. Change. Look. Allow. Feel in the body. Relax. And still very calm. Very calm. Yeah, no stress. So don't look too concentrated. Don't look concentrated. Yeah, don't look concentrated. Be concentrated. You come down. And also very consciously relax here. Yeah? Shift the weight on the right leg. Keep the balance. Open. Open. Feel the opening. Look far. That supports you and open. Grab and now slow. Feel how all the tendons, all the muscles are pulling toward each other. Pull, pull, pull. Almost automatically wants to open because there was so much tension. And here you go all the way open, 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 open until yeah, almost goes automatically. Automatically. Same on the other side. It's like when you extend a rubber band very, very much. You pull, you pull, you pull. And then you let go. Right? Then the rubber band starts to pull itself together almost automatically. And this means here you stretch, you stretch, you stretch. And then you relax. And then you must really feel that how the tendons now want to, like a rubber band, go together. And this you use. It's not your own power that you make so. It's you stretch, bam, 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 then release. And it's like almost automatically coming. Number six. Forward. Already you can visualize, you can imagine they are really having the power to the front. It's like from your nails, the nails are getting out of your fingers. Really sharp out and down here. From the back, from here, when you go down now, don't put the butt so, not like this. Don't go down like this. Here, try from here. Go so much to the front before you fall over. Don't fall over, but keep it here. Lift the head. Go. Here, keep the power to the front. Keep the power. Keep. First, open the shoulders, then open the wings. And concentrate back on the feet. And then start the next one. Number 7. 9 goes drawing the sabers, yeah? Remember? In the old movies, always cool, we always have two swords. Like this. One I grab from down, one I grab from up. One hand grabs the sword here, the other hand grabs the sword here. And then you have two swords in the hand. So this is...
It's okay.
So that means the torsion of the body when you make it. Automatically, the arm which goes up, the shoulder turns on that side to the back. Here, go more, then you can feel how all the tendons, all the muscles are contracting. Feel here. Be careful not from here. Now start bending this, then there is too much pressure on the lower back here. We don't practice the stretch here on the lower back. This one. Yeah, be careful not to make this one. It is here. Feel the torsion of the body here already. It's here, the torsion. Now if you want to increase this torsion, then don't bend like this. So here's the torsion. Now increase. What's important about this wave? You always must know where you are in the movement. Always follow the movement. Always follow, always know where you are. So, not like here and then suddenly, buck. No. Yes, okay.
8.
This.
Yep. Have some plates in your hand. And then
heels up,
hands, left hand, right hand, push, push down, head, pull up, head is pulling up, arms, push down, yeah.
Remember, arms, hands are pushing down, head is pulling up.
Then, number 9, number 10, easy for you to remember, because number 9, number 10 is both with the claws. After the plates, here. First bring both hands up to the chamber. Here. Feel your lungs, feel your breathing. Then, already from here, when the right hand starts, the eyes, yeah. See this hand here. Concentrate on this hand here. And with the eyes, now when you open, you see, follow. Here, be careful when you go now here to the side, the left shoulder. Don't open too much like this, yeah. Because what we want with the arm crossing your chest is that it closes down one part of the lung and the other one is more free. Yeah, and if you stay like this, then here the right one is like squeezed a little bit. Yeah, and when you stand here, relax, relax. Breathe. Just stay inside of you, relax, relax. This one, take the position. And now breathe. Breathe and feel inside. Feel, compare left lung, right lung. When you breathe like this, how does it feel? When you breathe like this, how does it feel? Yeah, and you realize when you're here, the left one breathes more. The left one feels a little bit more cold. Yeah, and when you're here, left one is closed, right one is open. Yeah, feels different. Then the way from here. Yeah. Now, when you breathe in and out. number 10. Come down. Already. When I make it, when I come down, I know what's going to be the next movement. I need to face my body like this. So, I come down. And almost here. Here now, my hip turns already. Down. Already halfway now here. And here. Chest open. Wait, front, far, 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 far. Breathing, relax.
Still relaxed. So.
Then 11, 11, 12. Both arms sink. Cross. Close the ears. It's like newborn. It's like a newborn. Yeah. So emphasis, concentration on the drums. Concentrate on the drums. Don't concentrate on the pain. And just go. So, and when you're down, hold. One, two, three, and then you go up. Open. And down again. Last one. Hands here. Cross. Yeah. When the hands turn, the neck turns. Release.
try with the hands in direction. You can still watch down here, no problem. Watch down, so when you're close to the ground, then now head. Up like this, your hands push down, head lifts up. Release a moment, turn to the left side. Here also now. These are the details, I would say. If you somehow can remember them, it's good. What more is there to say? Your spine. Always remember spine. We also say that the spine is the axis of life. The axis of this life, and there are four movements that this axis must be able to make. Without those four movements, we will have problems. So, and what must the spine be able to make? You must be able to bend. To bend the other way. Turn here. And to turn here. These are like the four basic directions, movements of the spine. You always watch yourself if you have problems doing them. Yeah. Because this four we need. If there's any problem with those four movements, later on will come problems with other movements. Because these are the basic ones that our body somehow must make. Now, besides the 12 organs that we have, the spine we also consider in a way like an organ. Because if you look at the heart, our heart makes a very the function of the heart is very simple. Pumping the blood and sucking the blood. Just like this. It always makes 1-0, 1-0. But the spine has another function. It carries all the nervous system inside of it. Which means if you have problems with the lower spine here, then maybe your legs are paralyzed. If you have problems up here, the rest of the body is also paralyzed. So that means the spine is also in a way a very, very important part of our body. Now, what do we know about the spine? Is it possible to train the spine? Well, what we know for sure is that in the morning when you wake up, you're a little bit taller than in the evening when you go to bed. This is what we know. Because during the day, gravity is pulling on your spine. Gravity is pulling on your skeleton. So that means we get a little bit shorter. And what gets shorter is like, these are all the separate bones of the spine. So, and they sit on each other like this. In the morning, it's like this. And then because of gravity and you walk and do things, then spine gets squeezed like this during the day. So. And then in the evening, you're smaller. So what is it that we are, let's say, doing in order to prevent this? Open the spine up, open, yeah, open again, open. So,
and how do we do it? Where is this one? When you're just standing, feel the spine. So, and now, the upper part of the spine, chin in, head up, chin in, head up, chin in, head up. This with the upper. And the lower part is the tailbone, Steißbein. The tailbone here, at the same time when the head gets up, the tailbone down. This is what we make with the spine. Now just so in between, whenever you have time, whenever you feel bored, whenever you're just standing around somewhere, and then this is like what we do in order to keep like the flexibility of the spine and also remove the pressure from the spine in order that body fluids, that body liquids can get in between there again. It's like you put oil there, that there's not too much friction on the spine. It's the same like this. Because at least until now, all of these practices, they work okay. Yeah, how do you know they work? How do you know what's the benefit of it? I have no problem. Maybe that's the benefit. Maybe the benefit is that at least until now I have no issues with no matter what. I have no power issues. I have no flexibility issues. It's maybe the benefit of all of these practices you don't realize so easily because it's just normal. Because having a healthy body should be normal. But you realize if something is wrong, yeah, well, when something is wrong, then you realize it very, very quickly. But if you're okay all the time, then it's not like a big bonus. Then it's like average. Yeah, but maybe average is what at the moment, first of all, we have to put our focus on. To first of all have an average, normal working body. Because if from the 365 days every year, when you spend 50 of them having pain in the body, this cannot be normal. Something's wrong there. In a certain age, it surely comes because of the usage of the skeleton and all of this. But nobody here looks so old that I would say you have the age. So, and that's why everything that can be trained, we try to train. Just that the normal, that the body gets healthy, gets vital again. So. And then it's easier to focus on other things if you don't need to worry about your body anymore. Then you can save your energy and care about other things. But as long as you have problems with the body, you are not free in the mind. Any final questions from your side?
If you would have two places to train Qigong, one in a closed living room,
the other one.
There you have the problem with some planes going overhead. Would you still use the other one?
That's no problem. See, in this environment here, maybe it's really easy for you to concentrate on yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's quiet, and the birds are singing, no cars, no nothing. Okay, it's good, but I think later this afternoon,
mm-hmm.
you return back to where you come from. But maybe there you don't have birds singing and and a quiet place like this. So does it now mean you cannot practice Qigong anymore? Well, it shouldn't. So if there are airplanes, it's a good practice. It's especially then a good practice to stay with yourself. Because the reason why the airplane disturbs you is because you're not with yourself. In the beginning it maybe is hard, but that's the thing. You can never avoid that you make your Qigong and then somehow a phone rings or a car drives by or airplane comes. Yeah, we cannot change that. So that's why, especially then, focus on yourself, stay with yourself. Put your attention back on the feet.
Mm.
Just ground yourself, root yourself again. Then enjoy the rest of your time here. Feel free to practice. I'm still here if you have any other questions. And if not, then see you again. If not in this life, then in the next.